I state your name.
I, Kevin De Leon.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support and defend.
That I will support and defend.
The Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of California.
And the Constitution of the State of California.
Against all enemies.
Against all enemies.
Foreign and domestic.
Foreign and domestic.
That I will bear true faith.
That I will bear true faith.
And allegiance.
And allegiance.
To the Constitution of the United States.
To the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of California.
And the Constitution of the State of California.
That I take this obligation freely.
That I take this obligation freely.
Without any mental reservation.
Without any mental reservation.
Or purpose of evasion.
Or purpose of evasion.
And that I will well and faithfully.
And that I'll well and faithfully.
Discharge the duties.
Discharge the duties.
Upon which I'm about to enter.
Upon which I'm about to enter.
Congratulations, Mr. President.
Thank you very much. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you so very much. Thank you. Please. Thank you. Thank you so very much. Thank you. Si se puede. Thank you. Thank you so very much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you so very much. Y se hizo. Thank you. Thank you so very much. Thank you so very much. Madam Chief Justice, thank you very much for bestowing us with this wonderful honor. Thank you very much from the bottom of my heart. Thank you so very much, Madam Chief Justice of the California Supreme Court. And to my beautiful daughter, believe me when I say that you make a father very, very proud. I love you very much. To the constitutional officers, as well as to the former Senate pro tems, especially Senate pro tem Daryl Steinberg, thank you very much. Thank you. And to my colleagues, both Democrats as well as Republicans, thank you very much for bestowing me with your honor here today. Thank you very much. To the members of the other body, the legislative body, headed up by our esteemed, wonderful speaker from San Diego, Speaker Tony Atkins, thank you very much. And to my colleagues, it's the House of Origin, where I initiated my political career, to the members of the Assembly who are present here today, both Democrats as well as Republicans. Thank you very much for coming. Thank you very much. What a beautiful venue. This is a grand public building and the centerpiece of my district. Now, I chose this venue because it is close to the working families who live right by this amazing venue. And these are the individuals who put me in office. It's also a visual representation of the innovative spirit that is California. 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 We live in the most creative and innovative state on Earth. People come from all over the world in search of real opportunity with hopes of achieving a better life. We are the eighth largest economy in the world. We sit at the cutting edge of a global economy facing both Asia and Latin America, making us uniquely positioned to capitalize upon our constant state of innovation. We attract more venture capital than anywhere in the world. We have enormous advantages to compete in this new world economy because, frankly, much of it was created right here. Despite these challenges, despite these advantages, we face challenges that threaten our long-term security. As I prepare for the challenge, as well as opportunity of leading the Senate, I spent some time thinking about what makes California great and what holds us back. On a night like tonight, I'm also thinking of my mother. I was raised by a single mother with a third grade education. She immigrated to America, to California, to give my two sisters and me a better life. I grew up in Barrio Logan in San Diego, a community full, there you go. A community full of hardworking people, and sadly, an industrial dumping ground with its more than its share of pollution, drugs, and violence. My mom took the number 34 bus every day to the homes on top of the hill, the homes with the ocean panoramic views, her days spent taking care of the elderly and cleaning homes till late at night. She worked her fingers to the bone to put a roof over our heads, to put food on the table, and put the clothes on our backs. Yes, I rose out of poverty thanks to a dedicated mother who labored on her hands and knees so I could have a better life, and because of the teachers who believed in me and allowed me to get a college education. And sadly, millions of kids today living in poverty simply won't have the same opportunities I had. This disparity has led me to one very important conclusion. Isn't it time we shatter the great American myth about pulling oneself up by the bootstraps? It's a fantasy. It's simply not true, because we all need help. As a great scientist, Sir Isaac Newton said, if I've seen further, it's because I've stood on the shoulders of giants. Every single one of us, whether rich or poor, has relied on someone or is relying on someone else for our own success. And reliance is nothing of shame. It is the American way. Washington, Lincoln, Jefferson, Chavez, King, Milk, Anthony, all American giants were great leaders that each attributed. All giant Americans, great leaders that each attributed their success to people who helped them along the way be great. Yes, my friends, hard work is critical. It is fundamental. But no matter how hard some people work, because of their lack of access, they are relegated to live differently, to live with less. The crucial element of success is in community. It's how we interrelate and support one another. We're at our best when we put our nature towards the common good, towards elevating everyone, rather than dragging others down or stopping them from advancing, or worse yet, doing nothing to help. This isn't who we are at our core. At our core, we're Californians, and we improve things. Now, we are greater when we come together, because by leaving some behind, as we do much too often, we all lose. Now, let me emphasize, we all lose. Now, we're rebounding in California. We're picking ourselves off the mat, and we're dusting ourselves off. The Great Recession was the worst economic recession since 1929. And now, our economy is growing again. We need to maintain fiscal discipline and reduce and eliminate our wall of debt. But we must also invest in tomorrow. Austerity alone doesn't build a future. California's long-term economic success depends on investments we make today. We must invest in our youth to secure our future in the state of California. To be truly great, we must target our investments to make certain more kids have a fair shot at their own California dream. In fact, every kid, regardless of who they are, regardless of where they come from, regardless of what language they speak, or where their parents are from, or where they were born, or their immigration status, deserves a fair shot to make it here. Every kid deserves a safe community with green parks and open space where they can play and exercise without fear of violence. Every kid deserves to breathe in clean air and drink clean water, no matter where they live in California. Every kid deserves a quality education with safe schools, small classes, and excellent teachers, and the best chance to graduate and to go on to college or a career technical education. Every kid deserves a fair shot to attend a public university that's both accessible as well as affordable. Expanding opportunities isn't just the right thing or the moral thing, it is the absolutely necessary thing. Now, let me say, smart budget decisions and helping kids are not mutually exclusive. Doing both is mandatory for inclusive economic prosperity. The California dream, as we all know it collectively, regardless of ideology, regardless of political parties, the California dream requires a highly skilled workforce and a healthy middle class. And to accomplish prosperity, we must broaden horizons to those who are currently shut out today. Now, my story should not be the exception. My story should be the rule. Now, some will say, and some will look at me and say, I'm here today because my mother worked hard, or because I studied hard, or because I made smart choices. Some others will say that opportunity is available to everyone at birth. If you work hard, if you play by the rules, the best thing the state can do is to get out of the way. Friends, I'm here today. I'm not here today because people got out of my way. I'm here today because people got in my way and helped me along the way. And this doesn't mean that government is always the solution. We must develop strategies where government facilitates solutions rather than always trying to be the solution. But let's not pretend. Let's not pretend that every child can be successful if they pull hard enough on those bootstraps. The reality is many kids, because of factors that are outside of their control, can pull and pull and pull and never rise up unless we as a society are willing to lift them up together. We're not stronger as a state when we get out of the way. On the contrary, we're stronger both fiscally as well as morally when we put the ladder of opportunity in the way and reach for all individuals. Now, instead of pretending we are successful simply because of what we did, we should honor those who helped us by doing for others what was done for us. I stand here because of you. I'm here because of the activists in the 60s and the 70s devoted to social justice and equal opportunity who gave me a chance to pursue a higher education. I'm here today because of the teachers who, beyond the odds, still believed in me. And I'm here today because of my constituents who honored me with their votes. And I'm here today because of my colleagues in the Senate, both Democrats and Republicans. And thank you very much to my colleagues. And as I hope you have seen tonight, I'm here today because of my mother and because of my daughter. They will forever inspire me to do the right thing for the next generation. Finally, I'm here tonight because of each and every one of you. We're all connected as one people. And in California, my friends, anything and everything is possible when we do it together. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, and God bless you.